What is up, people? I hope y'all are doing well in the quarantine. You guys are staying safe, staying healthy, and being smart. This is a little bit of a different video that Christine and I want to do for y'all. Actually, this is like, we do like a full-on tutorial. So if y'all want to get straight to the tutorial, you can go ahead and skip to, I think it's like 11 minutes and 55 seconds is like the straight up tutorial on how to catch redfish in the springtime. So y'all can just watch the tutorial at the 11:55, but this is a fun little video. Christy and I, we tore up the redfish. So let's get right to it, showing you guys how to catch these redfish in the springtime.
What tide are we fishing?
Dead low. I got a fish. Hold on, they're here. Yeah, they're here.
In a red?
Yeah. Alright, people. First fish of the morning.
Should I get on the
beautiful
camera?
No.
There he is. All right, first fish of the morning, you guys. Wow, it doesn't get any better than this. Literally first cast. First cast up in the spot. You know it's gonna be a good day when that sun just comes up and you're already... What? No, I meant like, you know, when you're like out at first light and you're just,
dang, that's a beautiful red.
Just getting on the fish. You know it's gonna be a good day. Alright, beautiful red fish right here. First drum of the morning. Beautiful red fish. Alright, y'all, time to let this guy go. See ya.
People, this morning starting out with good old faithful quarter ounce jig head and Z-Man MinnowZ Creole Croaker is the color, and I like fishing this one across flats.
Ooh,
ooh, Christy's
ooh
on.
Ooh. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
My drag is, it's not locked down, but
literally
it's
second cast.
Man. We are, this is springtime redfish fishing.
Okay.
We are in the first week of spring.
That's why I like it.
These fish are still schooled up kind of in their winter pattern. And, oh my gosh, this guy is running. Sure. Look how blue his tail is. That's cool. Pretty work. Second cast. Third fish into the boat for Jeff and I. That's second cast. Third fish into the boat for Jeff and I.
Look how red that thing is.
I know. How cool. It's really crazy to me how in different fisheries, these redfish can be different colors.
No, it's just more murky water. They tend to have more of a gold, and then clear water, it's more silver, but that is like picture perfect redfish.
He's, or she is beautiful.
Sweet.
And then check out that tail.
Bomb.com.
Very cool. Check that out right there.
Ooh. All right, people. So anyways, as I was saying, I love these quarter ounce jig heads right here. And this just quarter ounce jig head and the MinnowZ, because especially like this time of year, you can fish it really a lot of different ways. But two of the most popular are you can jig it, which is kind of like what we're doing. Or you can also kind of, you can swim it right just like this across a flat. So typically, like what I like to do this time, like when I'm trout fishing, I tend to get more hits on just the steady retreat, not more hits, but trout like more of like a swimming fish, and redfish, because redfish are kind of digging a little bit more. Redfish will still hit it when it's swimming, but redfish also really like it when you jig it, when you bounce it up on the bottom. Thank you. There's the fish. There we go. All right, y'all. Got one.
Look, you got the pop. Look at that. Look, you got the pop.
Still running. This fish barely knows he's even hooked yet. He's running right towards the boat. There he goes. Come on, do your redfish thing.
What's the redfish thing?
Where he goes crazy. He saw the boat. He's like, I don't like that. That's right. Come up in here, you beautiful puppy drum. Dang, these redfish are so beautiful. Beautiful morning redfish. Let me do you a solid. Take
Ew,
off some of these parasites, bruh.
Oh, God. Stop. Can you stop? That's disgusting.
He's got a little parasites on him, so we're not going to keep this. Christy's getting pretty grossed out.
Oh.
All right, y'all.
I don't know. That really weirded me out.
All right, going under this bridge.
I feel like we gotta do the limbo right now.
That's right. Hopefully, we can get up on some striper or redfish or speckled trout right underneath this bridge. Oh, this bridge just smells old, like old steel. All right, y'all, Christy and I, Captain Christy's on the wheel right now, and we are taking a cruise through downtown Norfolk, going to our next fishing spot. But y'all, check out what's behind me. There's like stacks on stacks on stacks of just these like crazy military, navy, battleships, aircraft carriers, army destroyers. I don't know any of y'all who are in the military. Actually, if y'all could comment what these ships are, that would be awesome. Because Christy and I are out here, we're driving past all these really cool boats and everything, all this military stuff. So if y'all can comment like what these are, that would be really, really cool. Like, what is that? That looks like a destroyer, if I had to say. That one right there looks like a destroyer. Those look like army boats, maybe. I don't know what that one is. That one looks like something out of like Transformers. And I think these ones are aircraft carriers up here, but I'm not sure. Yeah, so if y'all could like comment on this video, if anybody, I'm sure there's people, because we live in Virginia Beach, and there's tons of people in the military, which by the way, thank you for your service. We definitely couldn't be out here fishing and enjoying this amazing sport that we all love if it wasn't for y'all. So anyways, if y'all have any comments of what these ships are, that would be superb. Awesome.
Hey, you guys, I'm really excited to check out this brand new spot back here. Hopefully, it already looks like there's a lot of life, and where there is biomass, there's gonna be some game fish.
Oh yeah, feeling great.
Feeling good.
You know, there's sometimes you just gotta be open-minded, check out some new spots.
Yeah.
You know, don't be afraid to mess up. A lot of times when these fish are moving with the seasons, they come into these creeks where they've got like deeper water, but then there's like shallow water up on the flats, obviously, but they like deep creeks because then they can, when it's like really cold in the springtime, like now we have like 90 degrees today, but you know, again, it's kind of cold right now. Whoa, now it's getting really shallow. But these fish like, you know, some of these deeper creeks that they can pull up into and some of these flats so they can get some of that warmer water and then get more consistent water temperatures with the deeper creeks.
And how warm is it back here?
It's 59, but it's really shallow.
All right, y'all, got the city of Norfolk behind us.
Check it out, right there.
Big old battleships.
Check it out.
And currently on our way to our next location, but beautiful day. The sun is out and it just like went up about 10 degrees. So it's gonna hopefully be about 90 today.
That's right. There's actually people on jet skis. Check it out. Jet skis, big battleships. Y'all, it ain't even April yet and it is time. Look at this. The water temperature is 60 degrees. 60 degree water temp, people. So anyways, Christy and I were just heading down to the speckled trout spot. Christy lost the giant yesterday.
That's right.
We're just gonna eat some pistachios, enjoy this beautiful weather,
and we're just listening to some yacht rock right now on Pandora, which I highly recommend. Yacht Rock's a great station. Y'all just want to chill out. Cruising on the boat, eating some pistachios. The only thing we're missing is probably a glass of champagne, some wine.
Champagne for
something
breakfast?
Like that. Yeah, maybe some champagne would go nice right now, or, you know, some boat shoes.
Boat shoes?
Yacht Rock.
What are you talking about?
Yacht Rock, babe. You know, like champagne, country club.
Maybe like a mimosa.
Yeah, that's right. Ooh, mimosa. That'd be good. All right, people. We're going to get down to the speckled trout spot and continue this day of fishing. There we go. All right, you guys. Up on this flat. Ooh, yeah, that's a good one. Nice puppy drum. Now I got him. Y'all, these fish, they will come as close as they can up onto the shore, because this ground has been exposed. So we're here at high tide, and now this water up here is about 70 degrees. So these redfish, they come up in here, they get this warmer water. Daggone, that is awesome. All right, y'all, let me talk to y'all about catching these redfish in the spring up here on these flats. So springtime can be a really kind of finicky time of year for these redfish, especially down in like low country, Charleston, and your southern fisheries. Southern mid-Atlantic, I should say. The redfish, they've been schooled up all winter long, and but a lot of these redfish, they've been getting pounded by dolphins and anglers, so they're gonna be pretty skittish. A lot of guides will tend to use live bait in the springtime, but as the water does warm up, we prefer artificial lures. That's pretty much mainly what Kirstie and I use. But the water temperature is rising, and that's really like the main things are the temperature is coming back. So the fish, their metabolisms are speeding up. And they're still going to be earlier spring. The redfish are still going to be like packed tight in their schools. So the, you know, numbers of redfish you're going to get into in the early spring are typically going to be a little bit better than as the spring goes on. Just because these fish are still going to be, you know, schooled up as they are in their winter pattern. But, you know, so the main things are you've got the water temperature that's coming back. And then you also have the bait. You know, a lot of the life, the biomass is moving. All your stone crabs and fiddler crabs, you know, they start kind of coming back out and being active again. Let's say that we get some cooler nights and it gets down to like, I don't know, like 30s at night, and then highs in like the 50s for like 4 to 5 days for a consistent period of time. And that's where we might pull off of a flat and we might try like drop-offs. We might try some main channel docks or structure. We might go into a creek that has like some deeper water inside of that creek. Oh, there's Kirstie on a fish.
I've been looking for you, Red. Been looking for you. Woo! All right, right here in front of us, I think there's a nice little school of pups. All right, y'all, here we go. Time to release this beautiful redfish. All right, buddy. Oh, go on.
All right, y'all, so actually my battery ended up dying on my GoPro, and I thought I was talking to my GoPro the whole entire time after Kirstie just caught this fish. So it turns out none of the rest of the tutorial I recorded because obviously my GoPro died. So I'm actually gonna just finish this tutorial here in my office while I'm self-quarantining here in the garage,
And I want to, actually, this is probably even better. Let me put my camera up on the old tripod.
So this is probably better because now you guys aren't just looking at my hands reeling while I'm talking to y'all about how to catch redfish in the spring. So let me just get right to it. And I'm going to show y'all, first off, just my favorite baits and why I like to use these baits in the springtime. So I like to use anything like that mimics just like a small minnow, because throughout the winter time, these are what the redfish have been keying in on mainly as their food and their forage, have been mainly these, at least in the mid-Atlantic down through our southern fisheries, even into Florida. Yes, shrimp always work all times of the year, even though, let's say, like in North Carolina, South Carolina, even in Virginia, we only get shrimp certain times of the year. Doesn't matter. Shrimp will always work. So these will work. It's great because you can make keyed in casts on certain areas, especially in the springtime when you're fishing a flat, or if you're fishing around the dock, which, you know, docks are obviously some great locations to fish for springtime. So shrimp are great. But if I had to pick one, my favorite, it would be the Z-Man MinnowZ. Mirrolure actually makes one that's very similar. You can barely even tell the difference between these two. So color, I mean, I'd like to use Creole, Croaker, white, but I really like this color that Mirrolure has for their soft plastics. But as you can see, it's pretty much the same action that you're gonna get. But I really, really like, these baits because, again, this is the main food source for redfish throughout the wintertime and going into spring is going to be your small bait fish. So you really cannot go wrong with these right here. So you can just swim it across a flat. You can make keyed in casts. You know, you can jig it. So I'm fishing these on a 1/4 ounce jig head, a 1/8 ounce jig head, and also all eight, and even a 3/8 ounce jig head. That's where I've been catching a lot of my redfish as well, like around some of your deeper, like main river channels, bridges, and things of that nature. Again, especially like when these redfish, when they, like, let's say like 4 or 5 days, you get like a really cold pattern where the nights are into like the 30s, those redfish are gonna slip off those flats and they're gonna pull to where that water is a little bit more consistent water temperature. And so they might move to that deeper water. So again, that's where I'm in the springtime, I'm gonna be working like a shallow flat if it's a warmer day. Not to say that those redfish won't still be there on a cooler day, they absolutely will. I'm just saying, as a generality, on a warmer day, you're gonna get more activity up shallow. And then on a cooling pattern, you know, the generality is you wanna target those redfish and look for them, even like on a main point, like where they might hang up. So where they might hang up on a flat where it's warmer, but if that flat's adjacent to like a creek mouth point that has like a channel right next to it, or a flat next to like a deeper channel, is an ideal spot because that's where those redfish, you can pretty much key in on those redfish, whether it's, so those redfish might be deep, they might be shallow, you know, it's just one tight area that's gonna hold that biomass right there. So I'm gonna show y'all some lures that I don't like to use in the springtime. And that's gonna be something like a swimming bait like this, this Strike King Redfish Magic. This is something that's more of your just swimming it. You know, redfish, at least in the Virginia, North Carolina area, even into April, are still gonna be a little slow. They're not gonna be as keyed in on baits that are gonna be moving. I absolutely do a steady retrieve sometimes. I just don't like baits like this in the springtime because you pretty much only have one style of a retrieve that you can do. I like these other lures, I like these other baits because I can swim them if I want to. Like when I'm fishing deep, a lot of times I'll fish that 3/8 ounce jig head and I'll cast it right up against some bridge pilings, let it sink to the bottom, and then I'll just give it a steady slow retrieve on the bottom. So I will do a slow retrieve, but I don't like baits that only have a steady retrieve. I like baits that I can also bounce on the bottom because these redfish, still, I want to fish something that I can really control that pattern and I can apply the action that I want to apply to that lure, if that makes any sense at all. So redfish, I really like to fish it slow, and I like to fish it low as well. So I'm not gonna, still, so it's still a little early, you guys, for the popping cork, unless you're fishing with live bait and you're just using these as bobbers, then you can absolutely use a popping cork. But I find that a popping cork in the early spring, as spring moves, you know, it gets closer to, depending on where you're at, where your water temperature gets into the upper 60s,
then probably you can throw a popping cork. And even on a really warm day when those redfish are active, or just when the redfish are active and you get them feeding and you get them real schooled up, you can probably throw a popping cork. But I probably wouldn't, because when those redfish are in their schools, they're also finicky. So if you, I think a popping cork, it's just a little bit too much. You know, it can almost like spook the redfish. So I don't like to use things with a lot of noise, a lot of vibration. So that's pretty much it, y'all. Don't really like to fish the popping cork until it gets to that, I don't know, right about 68, 70 degree water temperature, when things really start to get moving. Let's see, what else do I have here? Yeah, so I don't know. So this is the Mirrolure package right here. It's pretty much exactly same profile, Mirrolure, Z-Man. I just really love these two baits right here. This is pretty much all I need in my tackle box to catch redfish in the springtime. The other one is Z-Man that I also have that I really like is this Z-Man Trout Trick. It's the Swimming Trout Trick Electric Chicken. This is another great springtime bait as well. So I don't know if y'all can see that or not, but this right here is an excellent springtime bait as well. I like this slender pattern. It kind of, you know, you get like a little bit of like a shrimp kind of imitation, but you also get a paddle tail with that. So again, y'all, really anything that mimics like a small bait fish is really going to get it done in the springtime. Shrimp always works any time of the year for sure. But as far as like where to locate these redfish, again, y'all, just look for those flats that are going to be near a main channel, or it's going to be near an area that those redfish can pull off to when that water temperature, you know, gets a little bit cooler. So I'm going to be looking for a flat that's maybe like right next to, like right inside the mouth of like a main creek that's off of the river or off the intercoastal waterway or off of the bay or even off of the ocean for that matter. You know, so a lot of your inlets and just like a flat right inside of your inlet, that's an area that I'm going to look for to target these redfish in the springtime as well. The water temperature is always going to, so the water temperature is usually going to be warmer, the further back you go into a creek or up onto a flat. So definitely want to keep that in mind, because water temperature is paramount in the springtime. If the water temperature is 2 degrees warmer or even 1 degree warmer, Christy starts looking at me like I'm crazy, because I start freaking out, because I'm like, oh my gosh, the water temperature is 58 right here. It was 57 at the boat ramp. So I'm really paying attention to really like the depth and the water temperature are kind of like the two main things that I really want to pay attention to aside from bait. Bait is paramount. So if you see life, you see birds, pelicans around the flat, then those are going to be things that you definitely want to pay attention to. Like if I'm cruising around and I'm looking at different flats, and I see, you know, one that has like a bunch of pelicans on it, it's got a few ospreys hovering around it, then that's an area that I'm definitely going to target, because pelicans and ospreys, they're following exactly what the redfish are following too. So anyways, y'all, those are just some quick tips to help y'all catch some redfish in the springtime. Hopefully that helps. If y'all have any other requests for videos that you want Christy and I to do, especially in this time of quarantine, I hope that we can help y'all catch more redfish after this whole thing passes, and at least we can give y'all some entertainment and really some information to help y'all out, so that when you guys are getting back out there on the water, you know, come hopefully summertime or whenever we can all get back on the water, that, you know, we can help y'all to really maximize your time out there. So please, please drop us a line, give us a comment below. I pretty much respond to every comment right now. I have absolutely nothing to do right now other than Christy and I, we go fishing on our boat and kind of self-quarantine out on our boat. And then we pretty much come back here and we hang out at the house. So that's pretty much it, y'all. Please let us know what y'all want to see and we'll definitely make it happen. So that's all I got for y'all today. Hopefully that helps y'all, and you guys get up off your butt and catch yourself some fish. Only if it's legal though. All right, y'all. Peace.